Focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable.
The Innovators Club. Inspire. Impact. Involve. Inspire to infuse innovation in everyday life. Generate impact by nurturing innovations. Involve through an exchange of ideas. Incepted in 2003, Marico Innovation Foundation is a not-for-profit organization in India executing the corporate social responsibility for the parent company Marico Limited.
Marico has seen exponential growth whenever we have innovated something which is different and which has been innovative. So the belief in innovation was very strong in our minds, and at that time innovation was not on the top of the agenda of most CEOs, and we felt that if we give thrust to innovation in the corporate circles as well as in the social area, it will help the country. So the objective of founding the Marico Innovation Foundation was to fuel innovation not only in the business sector but also in the social sector.
The foundation works towards nurturing innovations that have the potential to bring change and add immense value to the overall growth of the nation. A step in this direction is the Marico Innovation Foundation Awards, a pioneer in recognizing unheralded innovations. Started in the year 2006, this is a pioneer platform that identifies and awards innovations that hold the potential to generate large-scale impact.
The Innovation Foundation has evolved over a period of time. It is guided by Innovation Council members, and this is an external body which is not connected to the Marico's Board of Directors. We also have Innovation Awards once in 2 years. The whole objective is to reinforce innovation, to bring in awareness about innovation, talk about innovation in various forums, and we invite entries from both business, social sector. We take these awards very, very seriously. Unlike any award functions, we go much more in detail. So there is an independent jury which evaluates the shortlisted entries. Prior to that, there is an innovation knowledge partner. And last year we had AT Kearney as our knowledge partner, and they shortlist from 550 to something like 30 or 40 shortlist candidates, which is again goes through social jury as well as a business jury. It again gets shortlisted to something like 15 entries, post which the innovation knowledge partner goes and visits all these companies or these organizations, and they verify whatever claims are made. And they come back and it goes to jury number two, which after getting feedback from the knowledge partner, evaluates and decides on the winners. And finally, on average, we take about 6 or 7 winners.
Over the previous editions, MIF has recognized more than 50 innovations across all categories. The outcome was 8 path-breaking Indian innovations, each disrupting their respective industries. These are India's solutions for global challenges.
We also have a Global Game Changer Award, which is given by nomination, and the Innovation Council identifies organizations which can and which have played a very important role in taking a big leap and being a global game changer.
MIF's Innovators Club throws light on the 6 stellar winners of the Marico Innovation Foundation Awards 2018. This week, we feature incredible devices recognized for social innovation and Tonbo imaging, awarded for business innovation. Incredible Devices is the only catheter reprocessing system in the world that cleans catheters, making them reusable with 100% accuracy. The founders talk about their journey so far.
In 2009, I lost my husband because of cardiac disease. I couldn't save him. So that time I thought, I couldn't save him, but I want to save other people also. So I thought, how could we save other people's life? There are so many people who cannot afford this treatment because the treatment is very costly. So we start working on the project and we came with an idea of catheter reprocessing system.
After this deep personal shock, basically we were left only with one question, like how we can save others from sharing this unfortunate fate. So during our research, we came to know that like cardiovascular diseases are the number one cause of death globally. According to World Health Organization, 8 out of 10 patients die because they cannot afford the treatment cost. India has the highest number of cardiovascular patients, like 32 million cardiovascular patients. So seeking this, we started our journey at how we can work out and make this treatment cost effective or affordable. So during our research, we came to know that doctors perform angiography and angioplasty for the treatment of these diseases, and catheters are used. So basically, catheters are thin, long, flexible tube. International healthcare agencies such as US FDA, JCI, and other agencies issued guidelines for reuse of catheters, we are already doing with other medical devices, to make treatment cost effective. In lack of any automatic system, hospitals around the globe are cleaning catheters using manual method, in which they flush the catheter with the help of a syringe. But this method has several drawbacks. First of all, there is no patient safety assured, because diseases may get transferred from one patient to another due to inefficient cleaning. Second thing, the chemicals which are used for the cleaning of the catheters, one of the thing is they are very expensive and they're having a lot of health hazard to the labor which is deployed to clean the catheters. So labor safety is again at stake. There is no quality assurance and the method is quite expensive and the reuse is very limited. So seeking all these things, we started our journey in a quest to find the answers at how we can resolve all these problems. So in the research, Incredible Devices has developed the world's first and only available catheter cleaning machine. We call it as Catheter Reprocessing System. Basically, it's a computer-aided catheter cleaning machine with inbuilt self-test and calibration that ensures 100% cleaning of catheters every time.
Catheter Reprocessing System is an automatic angiography and angioplasty catheter cleaning machine which is developed to use at hospitals.
So we designed the device in a way that a layman can also operate it with a very minimal training. Like you just need to plug the catheter and press the start button. It's fully automatic. It automatically takes enzyme, multi-enzyme solution, RO water, and adopts the best cleaning program depending upon the soil state of the catheter, and cleans the catheter within 6 to 10 minutes at a very low cost of rupees 20 only, and makes catheter 100% patient safe. Incredible Devices started this journey with the cardiac patients, but we feel like cardiac patient is not the end of the story. When we interacted with the patient, we have seen like the pain of the kidney patient, interventional patients, means kidney, liver, and your neuro patients, brain patients, and vascular patients. So catheters are required in their treatment also, and the catheter, you won't believe, like for the kidney patients, cost around 32,000 rupees per unit. We have evolved the model of the CRS. So now the CRS can reprocess catheters for kidney patients, liver patients, brain patients, and vascular patients as well. So anywhere the catheter is required in the body, this machine can reprocess. We built single machine, which you just need to connect the catheter and it automatically detects which kind of catheter it is and adopt that particular program to clean it in an efficient manner. So that's the latest achievement we have made in this product.
Incredible Devices came up with the only catheter reprocessing system in the world that cleans and makes catheters suitable for reuse with 100% accuracy.
In India, there are 18,000 hospitals and 32 million patients. And to serve all these patients, we need to manufacture 10 to 15 machines a month. But with our capacity, we can only manufacture 2 machines a month. So to serve all these patients, we need funds so that we can increase our production facility.
The biggest challenge which we faced during the innovation journey was the finances. Because myself, I'm a single Narin by my family. And Rajvinder Kaur, she is again the single mother taking care of the entire family. So the challenge was the finances. So we started working in a hospital in a daytime, and in the evening we started working on this project. So there was a certain time like we were running out of the cash, and at that time we take a call with the support of my family. So we sold our house and started building this machine in my home garage. Like we shifted to a tin shed and where we built this entire device. So 2 months ago, we have shifted to this site to start the production. We have received the funding support from Government of India. So after their support, we have rented out this place, and with a team of 8 members, we have started the production. The value which Marico has it to the product, like the first thing, like their team came on the ground to support us. It's not like that over a telephonic conversation or something like that, or on emails. They actually work on ground. The facility which you can see over here is their team, production team, has helped us establish this facility in the term of their mentorship, their design expertise, their productivity, production manager's expertise. And apart from that, Marico had a solid, like they, whatever they say in the values, they actually do it on the ground also. So they help us in developing the marketing strategy. So in this way, like it's not, for most of the Indian culture, the award ceremony is a one-day program, but for Marico, it's like a lifetime interaction or a bonding with the end user.
New catheters cost 2,500 rupees and upward, while recycled catheters cost a meagre 20 rupees per use, a cost reduction of 99%.
Indian healthcare system, 80% of the finances which the patients are doing right now is out of pocket. Patients sell their houses, their savings, their every saving of their life just to save the life of their loved ones. So which is the irony of the system. And despite any kind of the government supports and the things on the ground still remains like this. So the challenge with the Indian system is like we import around 100% of the catheters or other medical devices in India, and the cost of the treatment is very high. So with the help of systems like CRS, we ensure 100% safe treatment to the patient without any infection and at a very affordable rate. So we are looking for a world or for a tomorrow where we can provide safe, affordable and accessible treatment to all, irrespective of patient's social status, their economic class and their geographical reach.
On the other side of the break, we bring you Tonbo Imaging. They design and build high-tech cameras and imaging systems for the defense industry. Imaging designs, builds and deploys advanced imaging and sensor systems to sense, understand and control complex environments.
What we do is we build imaging systems largely for the defense and surveillance market. If you look at defense in the last few years, right, at least over the last 50 years, it's always been a very asset-heavy industry. I mean, when you think about defense technologies or defense companies, you think largely, you know, companies with large assembly lines, plants, infrastructure, very capital intensive. My background's been in defense technologies. I used to work with the US Armed Forces till 2003, and you know, we moved back to India in 2004. And around 2007-2008, we were thinking about, you know, how can we look at potentially disrupting this old industry, which has always relied a lot on very capital intensive infrastructure. And one of the things which came to mind was, when you look at evolution over the last, you know, many years, traditionally, technology has been built for the defense industry and it migrated to the consumer industry. But if you look at technology development over the last 10-15 years, the technology development and the pace of technology development in the consumer electronics industry is far more than what's happened in the defense industry. So, and that essentially means that, you know, you have superior systems, both in terms of size, weight, power and cost in the consumer electronics industry. And so we said, well, can we do the reverse? Can we take innovations which have happened in the consumer electronics industry and move it to the defense industry? The entire focus of our innovation was, can you disrupt a defense industry by bringing in tech, commercial off-the-shelf tech from the consumer electronics industry? And from a technology innovation point of view, part of what we wanted to do was, we said imaging is pretty much critical to any kind of military application. So whether it's a UAV, whether it's a submarine, or whether you have large guns, 30% by value is the imaging system which goes onto it. So we said, can we change the way imaging systems are built today? I mean, can we look at different designs for optics, different designs for imaging, and largely to address the emerging market? So we were not so interested in the US market or the European market, because they do have a few suppliers, limited suppliers. But emerging markets are the ones which are looking at large-scale modernization, and they don't have access to a lot of this technology. And we said, can we redesign this process of imaging so that emerging markets can benefit from that technology, so you have at the right price point really high-end imaging systems, and then they become more competitive in the global marketplace. And so that's the heart of what we're trying to do.
Modern-day battlefields, critical infrastructures, unmanned reconnaissance, transport vehicles driving in the dark, all offer very challenging environments for effective visualization.
Challenge any defense startup faces is pretty much credibility, right? I mean, and you don't, when you're a startup in the defense world, customer does not know whether you're going to exist, after 3 years or 5 years, and he wants, credible support over a long period of time. And rightly so, because, there are a lot of things which have a life cycle of only 1 year and you can discard them, but military equipment need to last for 5-10 years. So establishing credibility that when you are a startup, even though you are well funded or even though you have capital to support the customer, the fact that you can actually build and sustain and be consistent with quality, that's the biggest problem initially, right? So credibility is a big challenge. And credibility is a problem not just the fact only from a Indian customer's point of view, right? I mean, and the other problem is that an Indian customer or emerging market customer faces is the fact that, have you done this before? Right? I mean, can you demonstrate that this product has been deployed? You have to be the first mover and say, I'll buy it. That means that you're putting your head on the chopping block if something goes wrong, and no one wants to do that, right? And take that risk. And I think that was the biggest challenge. And the way we overcame it was, largely to do with the fact that, use a lot of our personal credibility. As I said, our experience, my personal experience has been working with the U.S. Defense Forces. I have a very strong relationship with DARPA and U.S. Special Operations Command. DARPA's Deputy Director of Defense serves on our board as well. And we said, look, that credibility going and saying, well, okay, now we have done this in the past, maybe for a different organization and a different entity. Now we can replicate this model here. So give us a chance. And the good thing about U.S. is it's fairly meritocracy in terms of being able to give you a chance. So he said, okay, let's go try it out. If these guys work, then it's okay. And so, and they gave us a chance. They allowed us to build some systems initially. We demonstrated those systems worked. And then, of course, the rest of the emerging market started buying it. So credibility and the way to overcome is find few solid pilot customers who are not in the emerging market, but who are in the developed market, who can show that, what you're building is not good just because it's cheap. It's good because it actually is competitive in an international market space.
Tonbo Imaging offers a suite of solutions that address critical market needs in military reconnaissance, critical infrastructure security, and transportation safety.
So our innovations are twofold, right? We do exactly just two things at the core of what we do. One is an innovation in our entire business process of how we look at the defense market. As I said, fundamentally, at the heart of what we are doing is we are saying, can you use commercial off-the-shelf hardware and build systems which are rugged enough for the military market? That's from a business innovation point of view, saying that, and that's completely different from how people have traditionally thought about defense, where you said, let's build everything ground up and be vertically integrated. The second part of our innovation is, how do you redefine the sensing process, the imaging process itself, right? And as I was mentioning, that at the heart of every military system, nearly 30% by value is the imaging component on it, right? Whether it's a large gun or whether it's a UAV, whether it's a submarine, whether it's a tank, whether it's a rifle, the value which comes from that equipment is from the imaging part of it. So you want to be able to see the environment very well. You want to understand what's happening around it, and you want to be able to engage with targets in the environment. Our technology innovation was, can you use multiple eyes and a very smart brain to combine all these eyes and build imaging systems which are better than what exists in the world today? So our technology innovation is to redefine the sensing and the imaging process, and our business innovation is to change the entire way we think about how imaging systems are built for the military market. And so those are two core innovations of what we do.
The company's offerings consist of sophisticated imaging products, custom design applications, and intellectual property cores.
Interesting part about the Marico innovation as compared to a lot of these awards is the focus was, how do we showcase technology, How can we showcase people who are winners and who are entrepreneurs to say that, and you know, in their own words, spend a lot of time and effort to make sure that the message comes across very well, right? And normally, I mean, if it's a pure PR activity, it would be all about saying, you know, can I get maximum value for my advertising, you know, from my advertising budget. Marico has not done that, right? And their focus is all about saying, it's just incidentally Marico, but it's all about, here, we are supporting this ecosystem by bringing. And I think that's been very valuable because they helped us, you know, they had a really nice show in Bombay where we went and gave talks. Lots of people came there. We got to meet a lot of people, a lot of, industry veterans, investors, you know, a lot of people and personal network of Mr. Maribala. And I think that was very valuable because you get to talk and interact with a lot of people.
Tonbo Imaging leverages innovative designs in micro-optics, low-power electronics and real-time vision processing to design imaging systems for real-world applications. Tonbo's high-tech cameras and imaging systems will be used in the future by commercial industries like driverless cars and autonomous mining trucks.
We are working with smart city systems integrators around the world to put cameras on vehicles and cameras on infrastructure. So your traffic lights will have our cameras. The traffic light will already tell the car that I sense that there is a parked car there, so you need to slow down. Right? I sense that there are children playing there. They're going to kick a football which is going to come into your road, so slow down, right? And autonomous vehicles will need this kind of global information, right? So our next 5 years, so the last 4 years have been focused on building our defense technologies. We are in 25 countries. We have been able to scale up our revenue. We have been able to demonstrate that in a highly regulated, complex market, we have been able to build products and sell it to the customer. Now we said, can we take the same thing to a commercial market? Can we work with systems integrators around the world, cities around the world? So we are working with smart cities in Europe, smart city in China, looking at saying, you know, how can you take this technology and empower the next range of autonomy, which is going to happen in autonomous vehicles and intelligent transportation. So the next 5 years is going to be focused on expanding our defense business to more countries and focusing on growing our commercial business, which I think is a very valuable business down the line.
Next week on MIF, the Innovators Club, we feature groundbreaking innovations and winners of Marico Innovation Foundation Awards.
Focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable.